St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King, a legacy of domination for 50 years. Go Fish Ontario, it's catching.
Welcome back to Extreme Angler TV. I've got a treat this week. It's mid-September and we're in here. It's a fantastic day. When I'm wearing shorts and a, you know, not a hoodie, I know it's a good day in September. But we're in Algoma, Ontario, chasing this big, bad brown bass. And there's a smelt thing going on right now where those fish are starting to bulk up. Those cold nights are just inspiring them to, like a bear. We've got to eat. We've got to get out there. We've got to, you know, put on that big fat bellies and the extra weight for winter. So they've been eating the smelts and stuff. So my choice, this show, this day, is gonna be the Strike King Caffeine Shad. I'll show you the whole deal of what, where, how, when, the whole deal throughout today. But the 5-inch and 4-inch, trying to match the hatch. Just same way those guys do it when they're fly fishing. But this is a little bit more of a power technique, throwing it out with a big hook, heavy line, bait cast outfit, and trying to horse those big fish into the boat so I can make another cast and catch another one. So sit back and relax from friendly Algoma, Ontario. Hopefully you're gonna meet some of those big bad bass that you wanna hook up with when you come here. Let's go at it. Sometimes, you know, you say to yourself, it's fishing, right? It's all about catching. It's not, believe it or not. The catching is a bonus. Now it might sound weird, you know, you call it a fishing show when you're going fishing, but I'm telling you, man, it's all about the elements of going out, experiencing it, figuring it out. Right bait, right rod, line, where the fish are, how they want it that day. And trust me when I tell you, it changes throughout the day from hour to hour. Sometimes within half an hour, they can be really good, then they want it slow. It's your job as an angler, you know, to keep catching fish, is to change and adapt as the fish tell you what they want. You'll catch more and bigger fish. Oh, that's a big one. That's a good one. Oh boy, so we got a caffeine shad. My goodness. Back off a bit there. Wow, but I got a 16-pound gamma fluoro and it's as tough stuff. I change it all the time, man. Oh, you are a good fish. Wow, I love those smallmouth. Look at him. Just a beast, huh? I don't want to swing you. I don't want to bust any rods. Come here, boy. Come here. Whoa, they don't like to see the net, do they? Nope. Oh, that's not the beast of burden yet. Well, the chunky fish. Not a big giant fish, but a nice chunky fish. But it's just the way they bite. Boom, when they hit it. We're gonna let him go. Put him back here. Nice and safe, huh? What do you think, eh? You ready to go back? I'd say he is. Going out and just fishing these tapering edges and shoals in the morning. And if the wind stays down, I'm gonna try to stay out in that main lake basin where they're eating those smelts, where the really big pods of smelt are. And those real big ones, they just know it. They head out there like the big bear. But in the mornings, you know, fish the traditional points, shoals, edges close to the shorelines, because you know, you take advantage of that low light condition. You know, the sun's not that high yet, so all the bait is high and those fish come right up and they come even shallow. Shallow meaning 10, 12, 14 feet, or in the daytime, I'll be fishing maybe 35, 38 feet of water. So take advantage, you know, pace yourself. Don't just go by history. Oh, I caught them all out there the other day. Why not catch those fish that are sitting somewhat shallower? Because there's a reason they're in the shallower water, feeding. And a feeding fish is a dangerous fish, because that's an easier fish for you to catch. I'm gonna re-rig, try to catch another one.
Do it.
taper here. It drops off. It goes from 8, 12, 15, and then this almost, I call it the main lake basin, where it starts to taper to the main lake, and this is the main lake with the bay here. And I'm not making real far casts. That's 17 and a half feet of water right there. Now this, you know, I call it a power technique, and it is, because I'm using, you know, 6'8 St.Croix, medium heavy, 16 pound gamma fluorocarbon, a big four rod hook on a 5-inch bait. But it's very important to have that sensitive yet strong rod, because a lot of those bites, I'm, you know, casting at a fair distance, and also you just feel a little sensation. You wait a couple seconds, make sure that he grabs that bait. He could have had it here. I want him to turn it, so he's got that hook covered. Reel up any slack line, then hit him. That's the key. Reel up that slack line, because you don't want to hit him on a slack line. Then, you know, he's still holding on. You think you got the fish, but he's not hooked yet because you did not penetrate. Tighten up that line as much as you can. Utilize your rod. Reel up till you feel the fish, and then hit him. So sensitive but strong. That's the key to catch these fish, the caffeine shad. Oh, beautiful fish. My God. Man, oh man. Medium heavy action. I can force these fish to pull. There's one of the ones that we're looking for right there. Look how beautiful they are. Wow, what a beast. Look at them. They just do not want to give up, do they? Nope. Come here, boy. Come here. Whoa! Two for missing the net, Carl. Look how tough they are. Wow. Oh, just gorgeous, fat, smallmouth bass. Not a giant, but just a gorgeous, fat smallmouth. And here's the thing about these Algoma fish. See how long it is? It's just a nice average fish, right? But look at how fat they are. Gorgeous little things, just eaten up. And that's the beauty. It gives them that power to fight. We're gonna let him go too. We're looking for big mamas. Just gorgeous looking smallmouth. Look at them. Just perfect little fighters, man. You ready to go back? Wow. Those little things right there make my life. These things are such an addiction. You catch a bunch of fish all day. You think you had enough. You go to bed, and I find myself thinking about it. Wow, I can't wait to get out the next day. So it's all about, for me, the hunt, pursuing them, you know, figuring them out, how to catch them. And them giving me that pleasure, the utmost respect. Catch them, kiss them, let them go, get ready for another day to get my fix on smallmouth bass. Regroup, and hopefully catch a bunch more. Let's go. Now I'm sitting in 10, casting up to 17. I made about 4 casts and nothing. So what could be happening, those fish are slowly moving a bit, following the bait, either around the point, this way or that way, or going out. So just alter, don't just stick in one little spot. If you're catching fish, seeing, getting bit, that's one thing. But if you're not, come out a little bit more. You know, utilize the little bit of wind speed and the drift. Pull yourself out a little bit, try to stay on top of those aggressive fish. But the key is, as you go deeper, let this little bait fall a bit more before you start using your retrieve. Get in those fish zone. That's very, very important. I can't even go 10 feet without seeing tons and tons and tons of those little minnows. I don't know if they want a smaller bait. I'm not gonna think that because it'll mess with my mind. But I have that 4-inch caffeine shad well rigged up. See that? Oh, good one too. Pleasantly disturbed by a fish who finds my bait in the right spot. And you are just a nice one. Whoa! What a sweet sound that is. Hear that line just singing. Oh, lordy, lordy. Oh. Oh. That bait just sinking, and he found it. He's like, well, you be up there and you can gab. I'm gonna eat your caffeine shad. Wow, look how they dig. That's a scrapper. See what I mean? That's the size I was talking about. I've seen bigger, I've hooked bigger, but I mean, when they fight like that, God, is it fun. I think I'll net him because I don't want him to bounce around on my stuff. Oh, come here. Wow. Wow, are you nice, nice fish, man. that penetration right there. That is not going anywhere. A little bit of drag, let them pull. Watch that. That's it. That looks like a football, hey? I'll bet you Tom Brady could fire this 50 yards downfield. Touchdown! Football like smallmouth dudes in Algoma. Look at that. Like, I mean, it's scary, man, how nice they are. And the big fat bellies too, feeding up. Nothing like September smallmouth, man. Look at them. Just gorgeous, beautiful fish. Ready? Bye. I got on the water about 8:30 or so, and it's now about 10 or so. But that's the opportunity over here in Algoma. They have so many lakes, and just, yeah, they have some pressure and some anglers, but it's here waiting for you. You know that saying, like, go fish in Ontario? This is the deal, dudes, right here in Algoma. There's so many lakes, smallmouth, salmon, everything you want, pike, walleye. But for me, the thing that gives this boy that thrill are those brown bass right there. Take a deep breath, regroup, turn around, come back through, catch a few more, and then say thank you.
The Extreme Edge, presented by Strike King.
Man, I've got a new bait here that you know, I've been waiting for. This is a lure that I've really needed in my tackle box, in my toolkit, so to speak, for several years now. You know, the KVD 1.5 square bill has been a really monster success. You know, I've won a lot of money with it. Won a Bassmasters Classic with it. It's a great square bill that has that great erratic hunting action to it. But there's a time every now and then where I need one that's gonna run shallower, you know, that it just runs too deep. You know, when you got grass that's matted up close to the top, or you got super shallow rocks or super shallow wood, where you need a bait that you can, you know, really control the depth, but I still want that great action. So here we have it. This is the new KVD 1.5 shallow. Look at that bill on the front. You can see it's quite a bit different. It's got a steep angle to it. And this bait right here, if you fish it with fluorocarbon line and put your rod tip low, the maximum depth that it's gonna go is 2 feet. If you hold your rod tip up, you can control it so it's right underneath the surface. And the best thing about it is while you're reeling it along, it's jumping around. It's very erratic, and that's what triggers bass into biting. So if you need a super shallow crankbait, and there's a lot of times when that's the perfect situation and you gotta have something that'll run up high in the water column, the new KVD 1.5 shallow, it's money in the bank. I really like to fish it, you know, around real shallow cover or over the top of shallow cover, you know, so if you got grass, wood, rocks, vegetation, you know, anytime you can throw this bait over the top of something, you're gonna be able to trigger a lot of fish with it because it has erratic action. So, you know, I'm gonna cast it out there and, you know, just a straight retrieve, especially if you reel a little faster, this bait really jumps around. It's very erratic. It just doesn't come back in a straight line. So that in itself will trigger a lot of bass. But on top of that, I like to experiment with, you know, a quick start and stop, you know, a couple of times through the retrieve. A lot of times that'll trigger the fish, you know. I mean, if you got a bass and he's following it along and all of a sudden you stop it, they'll just automatically reaction, strike, you know, eat it right then. So I'm gonna do that and let the fish tell me what they want. Sometimes, you know, it's just a straight medium retrieve and let that bait do its thing. A lot of times though, starting and stopping it's gonna be one of the real keys. This bait really only runs, you know, a maximum of 2 foot deep. So if I gotta run it real shallow, I'll just hold my rod tip up and that'll keep that bait just right underneath the surface. If I want it to get down a little bit, I can drop the rod tip. That's really all there is to it. This bait is designed to just fish 2 foot or less. And, you know, it's a great tool when you're faced with those type of conditions or that type of cover. So the KVD 1.5 shallow, and it's definitely an addition that you have to have in your tackle box.
Birch Lake Resort is the ideal vacation resort for fishing, hunting, and camping. It is the perfect resort for individuals, families, or small groups who enjoy a quiet and relaxing getaway in any of their lakefront cottages. Experience the sunny southern exposure with clear scenic views of the secluded and peaceful lake. Birch Lake Resort offers a great fishing experience for anglers of all ages to fish for northern pike, smallmouth bass, perch, and catfish. Birch Lake Resort offers five charming lakefront housekeeping cottages. Each cottage has a fully equipped kitchen, three-piece bathrooms, and free Wi-Fi that all the guests can use. Contact Don Saint-Jules to book your next relaxing outdoor vacation.
You think I'm serious about these caffeine shads? I got this 5-inch and 4-inch in the little ghost shads, the KVD Magic, the Pearl Blue, the Pearl White, Chartreuse, killer. Bubblegum Pink, can't beat it. Ghost Shad again, it looks exactly like those smelt falling that have been injured by those bass. And the Pearl White just offsets the flash with the sun. With the Glacier, for me, with a little bit of blue, flip-flop blue, it is a money bait. Okay, today was fantastic with the 6'8" Legend Extreme St. Croix. Medium heavy with 16 pound gamma fluorocarbon, 4-odd wide gap hook with the Strike King 5-inch caffeine shad in the Glacier color. I played around a little bit with the 4-inch, didn't even have to go to the white pearl. The Glacier did it all. Sometimes simpler is best. Holy cow, that's the same size too. Oh my God, man, what a fishery. Wow. Wow. Holy lordy. Let me pinch myself for a sec. No, I am still alive. This isn't bass heaven. I'm still alive. You know when they're tight like this, your line gets tight? It's like this, listen. That's called guitar swinging. Oh, look how big you are too. I'm gonna let you go. Oh, I need another big one to take a picture with my big one. Come here, big girl. Come here. I know, if you get off now, it doesn't matter. Oh, right through the yap, man. God, I love that bite. Look at that, just a solid football. Remember what I said before about Tom Brady, you know? He'd throw these. Ready, set, touchdown. Woo! Love fishing Ontario. Today the deal was letting that bait fall, having confidence in this little caffeine shad. You know, the 5-inch falls a bit faster than the 4-inch, so when I was in that 9 to 12 feet of water, I could count a few seconds and start my retrieve in a cadence because those fish were high in the water column and very aggressive in feeding. But as I pulled out to 12, 15, 17, 20 feet of water, patience. Let the bait fall. I want this bait in that zone where those fish are, that they're comfortable in feeding. You know what I mean? So let it fall on a slack line. Have confidence that the bait is going to attract bites. As you saw, I had some bites sometimes just when the bait was falling on the original cast. Let it fall before you start your retrieve. That's the key to the caffeine shad. Monster. That's a big, big fish. Wow. What do you say about Algoma, dudes? It is definitely land of the giants when it comes to smallmouth bass and excitement. You just can't beat, man. Fish are just brutes. Come here, girl. Come on back here. Come on. Come on. I know. Oh, wow. What a way to potentially end my day. I got you. Don't worry. I'm not going to let you go. But man, oh man, when you can go to a region of Ontario and catch them like that, with that caffeine shad, man. Algoma Country. I'm gonna put this one in the live well, take some pictures, let her go. But if you're considering your next vacation, for you, your family, your friends, come on down to Algoma, dudes, because you gotta fish in Ontario, because we have these big brown bass waiting for you. Let's put her in there. She fought like a beast. She earned her respect to be released. Go away from your girlfriend. And now I'm done. Day's finished. You know what I mean? I lost a couple like that, but who cares? I made some memories for the bank up here. You saw it. Come on down here. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV in the land of the giants, Algoma, Ontario. Thanks for watching.
Experience this magnificent wilderness paradise. Contact Don St. Jules at Birch Lake Resort to book your next relaxing outdoor vacation at Birch Lake Resort. Young Steel's Ford Lincoln, Gamma Fishing Lines, Ragetail Soft Baits, Interstate Batteries, Top Gun Marine, Rockwood LED. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.